It's a well-known fact that whenever the TV or the press start talking about young people, and youth cults in particular, they get it completely wrong. So we've got a bit of a mod into the studio here this afternoon who's going to do a little bit of a speech for us, and then we're going to all have a bit of a discussion and try and get it right. So take it away, Tony.
The London street scene today is proliferated by innumerable youth cults, ranging from skinheads to soul boys, punks to mods, or rasters to rockers. Yet very few of these cults seem to be able to get on with each other. In fact, quite a few of them have one defined enemy. For example, skinheads appear to hate mods, obviously for no apparent reason than the fact that they look different from them. So, why belong to a cult at all? Is it worth getting your head kicked in just because of the length of your hair or the colour of the socks you wear? Is it an identity crisis that we've got, that we have to belong to something, or are we genuinely attracted to the music or the fashion or the image of a certain group?
Right, the 2 points I got from that was, is it dress or is it the music, or is it just a chance to, that's 3 points, or is it just a chance to beat somebody up? Anybody here that's had recent experience of either being beaten up by another cult or being involved in doing the same to another one? Anybody here?
I live in Richmond, right?
Yeah.
And all the mods come down there on a Wednesday and Sunday night to have a good time, right? I hang about with my mates outside because we're barred from every pub in Richmond because we've got short hair and boots, right?
Yeah.
Now all the mods, they go around there and they're bleeding partners and all this business, and they're let in, right? So why shouldn't we be let in? So we hang about outside because we're barred. Next thing you know, the mods come out and steam into you. You get your head kicked in.
I got mugged by 8 skinheads in Camden once.
That's being outnumbered, isn't it?
Yeah. I got beaten up while I had all my money mixed.
What, because you was a rockabilly or just because you was walking along the street and they were out to mug
something? Because he was on his own.
Because she was on your own.
Most likely, yeah.
Fair enough. Over there. Yes, it's your big moment.
I just want to say that it's not all the kids that beat everybody up. You can get mugged in the tube, you can get mugged walking in the park, and it's not all the kids' fault. You see flashers. Don't tell me I'm a flasher doing stuff like that, so it's not all kids' fault.
Right, anybody else who's had, you know, experiences like this? Perhaps say somebody who at work has had trouble because, you know, you go to work dressed like a lunatic or whatever, and your bosses don't like that either. Anybody had that sort of trouble? You must have done. I did. Nobody? You've all got great employees. You're all unemployed, of course, I forgot. Anybody who couldn't... All right, over there. Right.
I work for the in the civil service.
He's a tax man, he's a tax man.
And they're probably watching, on Monday, and I got a bit of trouble when I went in first. I sort of did it in stages, fooled them, like, you know. A little bit of colour to start with and sort of build it up. But, I mean, they're all right now, they accept it, you know.
Yeah, because you did it gradual.
Gradual, yeah. But, because I've got no guts, that's why. But, I mean, you still get trouble in pubs and stuff, and people not serving you. And tend to get more trouble from straight people than from skins and rockabillies, whatever, because I've got all right. Yeah.
And it's no use telling these people in pubs that you really work for the Inland Revenue and you're a decent soul.
They don't believe you.
No, it's terrible. Let's have a few people saying some things about perhaps why you decided, you know, because, I mean, look, I didn't always have hair this colour, as you may see from the roots, right? Perhaps somebody could say, you know, why you decided to do that and when you first, you know, did something like that and the reasons for it. And just quiet, just let them say it. All right, over there, you've got a rockabilly haircut.
Well,
why?
Well, it all happened about 5 years ago.
Yeah.
My little brother turned 10.
Shh, keep it down, please.
My little brother turned 10. He came home one day. I said, what are you trying to be, a silly teddy boy, you know? 2 weeks later, I went out and bought a drape suit, you know, done exactly the same thing. But now it's become a way of life. It's just the way of life with us.
Well, why did you buy it in the first place? Did you just like the colour?
Well, it was my younger brother sparked me off. I thought, this is what I want to do. This is the direction I've got to go
in. It's everything. It's the music.
It's the music.
Because there's a music. It's what you see. We've not said much about the music. And I mean, the music's very good, to say the least.
The music.
Right, down in the front.
It's what you enjoy.
It's the music that you enjoy, and it's the style.
Yeah, everybody enjoys their own type of music, don't they? And their own way of dressing. So that's what they do.
And it's also good, don't you think, are any of you sort of, I know you lot are in a group, but there's also a thing, isn't there, about being in a group together. You know, you all think the same, and you don't have to have arguments like this every day of the week. Isn't that right? I mean, if you get it from your parents, you get it from your employees, you get it from school, maybe. If you've got friends looking the same, you know, it makes life easier, doesn't it? Yeah.
Well, I think, most of the people who live in our area and at our college don't have an image, because I think we grab hold of something more concrete, like getting on with life and thinking of the future.
Yeah.
And we don't go around causing trouble, we're not boring, and we have fun.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right, somebody else. Yeah, okay, over there.
Somebody does something to the girl over there, has her hair done like that, and somebody agrees it. Somebody thinks it looks good, so they have it done the same. It's not joining in and being, say, anonymous within a group. I mean, you couldn't call any of these, the punks, anonymous and samey. I mean, if they think something looks good, they dress like that. I mean, women's fashion. What's women's fashion?
Yeah.
They see something in the magazine, oh, that looks nice. And they go, oh, dress like that.
So, what we've talked about, violence, clothes, uniforms, being individual or not individual. And we're back to square one again, aren't we?